Hello students, today our topic is Lewis theory of acids and bases. In the last session we already discussed about Bronsted-Lowry theory. Then again why another theory? Because the Bronsted-Lowry theory has some drawbacks. It cannot explain about all the acids like beryllium chloride, BF3, BCl3. Like this, these are the electron deficient compounds. These kind of compounds the Bronsted-Lowry theory failed to explain, okay, because to overcome those drawbacks the Lewis proposed one wonderful theory. This is very very important theory. He proposed the theory based on the electrons, first we'll start with the definition. According to the Lewis, acids are the electron pair acceptors. In the today's session we'll discuss only Lewis acids. According to the Lewis theory, acids are electron pair acceptors. If any compound, it can accept the electron, that acts as a Lewis acids. Okay, now I will give some important tricks to find the Lewis acids. These are very very useful for you. Remember the definition, electron pair acceptor acts as a Lewis acids. Now we'll see, almost all cations are acts as a acids. Almost all means why not all cations acts as acids? Because if all the cations can acts as acids, they should have vacant orbital. There is no vacant orbital. Vacant orbital means empty orbital. If there is no empty orbital, the molecule or compound that cannot receive the electron, that cannot accept the electron pair. Yes, see, electron pair acceptor is Lewis acid. If there is no vacant orbital, there is no acceptance. Okay, there is no empty place to accept the electron. That is why only few cations are acts as a Lewis acids. All first A and second A group cations acts as a acids. Few cations does not acts as a acids. Rest all acts as a acids, because for example, if you take Na plus, sodium cannot acts as a Lewis acids. Why? Because see, sodium atomic number 11, write the electronic configuration students, 1s2, 2s2, 2p1, right? Sorry, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. See here, one electron in the p orbital, it is completely filled, 6 electron. Okay, is there any vacant orbital to accept the electron? There is no vacant orbital, so this is not acts as a Lewis acid. This is the trick number 2. Remember this. Second one, electron deficient molecules. What is meant by electron deficient molecules? Electron deficient molecule means the octet, it does not contain the octet configuration in their valence shell. There is no octet configuration. These kind of compounds are known as electron deficient compounds, molecules or compounds. We'll see one example, BF3. In BF3, the central atom is the boron. What is the electronic atomic number of boron? Atomic number of boron is 5. And write the electronic configuration students, 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. See here I am writing only valence shell electronic configuration, outermost electronic configuration I am writing here. The p orbital, only one electron is there. In the excited state of boron, the one electron from 2s, it shifts to 2p. Still we have one vacant orbital here. Vacant orbital is there. So it can accept the electrons, like it can accept the electrons from molecules like ammonia. Ammonia has lone pair of electrons, so it can form bond BF3 NH3BF3NH3. So here the boron is accepting the electron pair, so the boron acts as a Lewis acid. We are not discussing about the bases. If you can think, if you want know about ammonia, here the ammonia is giving the electron pair to the boron, so it acts as a Lewis base. The BF3 acts as a Lewis acid. This is the Lewis base. Okay. Now we'll go for the trick number 3. See here, molecules in which central atom can expand its octet. The molecule it capable to expand its octet means it should have the d orbital to expand the octet. See here, we'll see the examples for that. Silicon fluoride, TeF4, FeCl3, SnCl4, these are the examples for these kind of molecules. Now we'll take SiF4. What is the central atom here? Si is the central atom. What is the atomic number of the silicon? 14. Write the electronic configuration. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p2. Okay. In this, it is present in the third shell. Okay, it is present in the third shell. In the third shell, s, p and d orbital is also there. Okay, in the third shell, d orbital is also there. So, it can expand the octet. In this case, here the possibility is there to expand the octet. So, these kind of molecules act as a Lewis acids. Okay, this is also very important trick. This is the trick number three. Now we'll go for the trick number 4. Molecules with multiple bonds other than carbon-carbon multiple bonds. It's very simple. Molecules with multiple bonds other than carbon-carbon multiple bonds. For example, the compounds like C double bond C, C single bond C, C triple bond C. These kind of compounds does not act as a Lewis acids. Other than these compounds can act as a Lewis acids. This is the trick number 4. See here, SO2, CO2. These two are different compounds, different molecules. Okay, sulfur is one atom, oxygen is the another kind of atom. In the case of CO2 also, same. NO2 and HCl, etc. These four tricks are very important. Take the screenshot. These four tricks are very, very important. Trick number 1. Trick number 2, trick number 3 and trick number 4. Okay. Hope up to here you can understand. If you have any doubts, we'll discuss later. You can comment. We'll discuss in the next class. Or you can comment in the comment section. I will help you see. Now we'll see the drawbacks of the Lewis acid base theory. Do you have idea about neutralization? Neutralization means if you take any acid and base, it will the reaction will complete in very, very less time. But according to the Lewis acid base theory, the neutralization reactions are fast, but as per Lewis, it should be slow. This is one of the drawback. And another drawback for the Lewis acid base theory, it could not explain the strength of acids bases. Which is strong acid and which is strong base, like that. This is another drawback. And another drawback of the Lewis theory is could not explain the catalytic activity of hydrogen ion, H plus ion. Now we'll see some example for this Lewis theory, Lewis acids, then you will get some idea. I will give some examples here. Can you find that which is Lewis acid? Bases we are not discussed, so you can find it. Which of the following molecules or compounds? Molecules acts as a Lewis acids. Lewis acids. AlCl3 OH minus H plus F minus CO2 etc. These compounds. See, first one AlCl3 aluminum chloride. It is the electron deficient compound, so it acts as a Lewis acid. Lewis acid. What about this minus? We said that all except few, rest all positive cations acts as a Lewis acid. So this is not Lewis acid. What about this? We can say blindly this is H+, so it acts as a Lewis acid. This is not Lewis acid. Negative ion, anion. What about this? The last trick we discussed, CO2. Multiple bonds. Molecules with multiple bonds other than CC acts as a Lewis acid. So CO2 also acts as a Lewis acid. That's it, students. Once we'll recall the topic, what is Lewis theory? Electron pair acceptor. After that, these four tricks we discussed. Practice this. And we discussed drawbacks and then some questions we discussed. This video will help you. In the next class, we'll discuss about Lewis bases. Thank you.